Hi everyone, this is Ur. I was reading the comments you made in the Google sign-in video, and one of you asked that how we can use Lucia in the client side. I have made a demo for this. Let's see, I will refresh page. You can see client user is null, and then we fill it with some information. So let's learn how we can do that. First of all, I will create a new component and call it client-user.ts. I will mark it with useClient. Here it is. And then I will call this component in my page like this. If I go to my page, I only see client-user. Okay, great. And you can see that in this page, we get user from validate request function. Let's go to that function and see what is going on there. It's in lib-lucia here. So we are getting the session ID from cookies and send this session ID into a function that Lucia provides, which is validate session. If I click on that, we can see the TypeScript types. And as you can see, it gets a session ID and it returns a promise that includes user and session. That's great. So what if I call this function inside my client component? So let's create a use effect here, which will work on mount. And I will say validate request. Then once it's resolved, we will just log the user. You see that we get an error. It says you are importing a component that needs next headers. Since validate request requires cookies from next headers, which is only available in the server side, but we are calling this function inside a client-side component, it's not possible. One way doing this, marking this validate request with use server, but if I do that in here, it won't work again. And we should do that inside a file that we marked with use server. You remember that we mark on the top of file, like use server. It's only possible if I do that. But we will do a different thing. Other possible solution is that we can go to our layout and you can see that we render our children here. If I create a component, which will be session provider in our cases and put our children into a session provider and give our session as props to the provider so that every children will be able to access these props. So let's do that. And the reason we can do it in the root layout, we render our pages inside layouts, and also we can do layout as async function so that we can also fetch this user inside our layout. So now we have session data inside layout, which is generated in the server. We can log this session data and see. But before that, let's get rid of this use effect. And we don't have a provider yet. So let's create it. I will go to providers and create a new providers. It will be called session provider.tsx. Great. I will define an interface for our session provider. And we can see its type from here. It returns a user and a session. So we will have a user, and its type will be user that comes from Lucia, and also a session, and its type will be session like this. I will create a new context here, session context, and we will need to import create context from React and then create a session provider that gets a children and a value. Let's give them type like this. And we will just render children inside our session context provider. And as a value, we will get these values as a props and we will pass them into the provider. So yeah, and then we can just say export const use session, and we can say session context use context session context like this. If session context is not exist, it means that we have made a mistake. Otherwise, we can just return the session context. In this way, we don't have to define our session context in every file like this. Instead, we can just call this use session function. which is great. And we will need to export session provider as well, so that we can go to layout right now and import session provider and pass our value, which will be the session data that we have just get from the validate request function. We get a TypeScript error. Type user null is not assignable to user. Okay, let's see. I think this can be null as well. Yeah, error is gone. Now let's see, but we forgot to mark this with use client. That's why we get an error. Now we can see our page. If I take a look in the server console, I can see that we get our session and user information, which we logged in layout. And after getting the session data, we just pass this into session provider, which we render our children. And even though session provider is a client component, we can render server components inside it. For example, session provider renders the whole page. Whole page is a server component, even though session provider is a client rendered component. And this page has also a client component. It may be a bit complicated, but it is how it works. And now, if I go to my client user and I can use session that we have exported from session provider, and it returns user like this. Let's take a look at. Now I'm able to reach user's information inside a client component. How we can be sure? I mean, it's marked that as use client, but let's say you will modify this user after some operations, and I will say modified user, set modified user, and it will be a state. And let's have a use effect that we run on mount, and let's have a timeout. After 3 seconds, let's put a new field to user, log modified user. Now you can see our user is there after 3 seconds. So that's how you can access user in the client side. Lucia does provide a function, validate session, that returns user and session, that we can actually run this function inside a server component, which is our layout.tsx, and we can pass this information that we get from the function to a client component and use there. And we have use provider as a client component, so that every client component can reach this information later. It's for this video. Thank you for watching. Take care. Bye-bye.